I'm a broken home. I gave you all the bricks that I own and know. I'm letting go. I'm breaking.
Hey guys, it's Natalie. Welcome back to my channel. I wanted to talk to you about motivation, getting back on track, what happened when I gained all this weight and how I lost it and just got back to a healthy lifestyle. So first I wanted to talk to you guys about what happened, why I gained so much weight in the first place. I did make a video talking about the emotional things that I was going through. I'll link that video down below. So I had a combination of a few things that are like the worst things to maintain a healthy diet, which are poor sleep and stress paired with a diet that is high in calories but low in nutrients. For me, it caused me to blow up. I gained a bunch of weight very quickly. I wasn't feeling good. My skin was breaking out. Like basically my whole body was not doing well. So first I had to address the problem why I wasn't feeling well. We had moved. I had a lot of changes going on in my life. My sleep patterns got messed up. I was either oversleeping or undersleeping. And then I was eating at all different times of the day. And like I said, I was eating food that was high in calories, but not really full of nutrients, which I needed. So to get back on track, and this is something that I did personally and that I recommend to my clients when you're beginning to make a lifestyle change, particularly about your diet, is to make one good choice a day. So I started with my first meal of the day having something that was really good for me, a very nutrient-dense meal, at least just one. And if you can do one thing a day that is good for you, not only does it help motivate you and influence your decisions throughout the rest of the day, but it helps you feel better and gives you a little sense of accomplishment. Like, I did this one thing, this is doable, maybe I can accomplish more and try for bigger goals next time. So for me, it was my one meal. And this is something I recommend to my clients. Just have one meal that's good for you. Don't change anything else. Just change one meal a day into something that is full of nutrients. It's really gonna feed your body. And then if you wanna eat crap the rest of the day, you know, we'll deal with that later. And usually what I find is that they don't. They start eating better, feeling better, and it gives them that little sense of, I did this and I could do more. So once I was consistent for about a week with eating my one good meal, I started feeling better about myself, better about my choices, and my energy started to go up a little bit. I started implementing intermittent fasting again. So I started with 12 hours a day, doing 12 hours where I didn't eat, I only had water. And this is so easy because I started while I slept. So I'd stop eating at 8 o'clock at night, have water till I went to bed, and then I wouldn't eat anything until 8 o'clock the next day. I continued with that pattern for about a week, and then I bumped it up an hour and an hour, and it took about a month and a half to where now I am successfully fasting every day for about 15 to 17 hours. And as soon as I started the intermittent fasting again, where I got to about 14 hours, I just had rapid weight loss. I felt like I was losing the weight as quickly as I had gained it. I did start working out about once a week. I teach a 1 hour class once a week. And I wasn't like working out excessively. People think you have to spend hours in the gym or a lot of time killing yourself. Really, it's all about your diet. If you could eat well and then feel well emotionally and sleep, you know, pretty normal schedule or get enough sleep so you're rested, you're gonna notice significant improvements in your health, in your diet, in your cravings. You're just gonna feel better. And the last thing that I think is so important to maintaining a long-term lifestyle change is to reach out for help. Have people that you can count on, that you can trust, that will help make you accountable for the changes that you wanna be able to have for a long time. So for me, I had to reach out to some friends and family, and I also had to let go of guilt and shame of my weight gain. I felt embarrassed because I gained weight. I didn't want to make videos. Like, I'm a personal trainer. I felt like I knew better. And I'd been through things much more dramatic and emotional in my life. Like, I don't know why the move upset me so much, or I was having such a hard time adjusting. I kind of let it affect all aspects of my life, and I was embarrassed about it, honestly. So I had to reach out, get help, get someone who helped keep me accountable, and just let go of the shame and guilt, because you're not gonna feel better and be able to make changes if you're too embarrassed to reach out or tell anybody, if you're alone. There's no reason to be alone. I think we are created to communicate with one another and be able to depend on each other. And if you feel like you can't do that, doing stuff on your own is really hard and you shouldn't have to do things on your own. So in my video where I talked about when I was depressed, I told you guys that you can reach out to me for help because I'm here for you guys. I think one of my gifts is training and helping people make lifestyle changes. And so I'm here for you guys. If you gain weight or you're depressed or you're just having issues, I've been through a lot of stuff and I want you guys to know you can reach out to me. I will put my Instagram down below. I check it all the time. I'm on YouTube about two or three times a week, so I don't answer my comments every single day. Sometimes I do, but most of the time I don't. But I am on my Instagram all the time, so that's like direct access to me. If you guys need something or just want to say hi, I want you guys to know I can be your accountability buddy too. Something else I want to throw in here really quick is visual reminders. Everybody has something different that helps motivate them. For me, I'm very motivated by visual reminders and seeing things. I literally wrote myself little notes. I have my dream board hanging here where I have pictures of healthy food, gardens, people working out, like different goals that I wanted to reach. And seeing them every day kind of helped remind me to, you know, make better choices and to feel better and to know that where I am, I'm not stuck and I can make a change for the better. And if you guys have any tips that you wanted to share, please leave comments down below. I want my channel to be a place where people can openly and safely communicate with each other and share their ideas. And if I didn't mention something that helped you or you think something would really be helpful to somebody, then just leave a comment. I'd like to share that and create a platform where you guys can share that. That's it. That's all I want to talk about in this video. I hope you guys have a great day and you make good food choices and feed your body well, because it's the only one that we have, so we need to take care of it. I'll see everybody soon. Bye guys.